Believe me, they don't come much cheaper than me. I'm gonna be.
Okay. I'm working.
No peace. No peace.
No justice. No justice.
No peace.
No justice.
No peace.
Come on. No justice.
No peace.
No justice.
No peace.
Come on. No justice.
No peace.
No justice.
No peace.
Come on. No justice.
No peace.
No justice.
No peace.
No justice.
No peace.
No justice.
No peace.
Come on. No justice.
No peace.
No justice.
No peace.
Come on. No justice.
No peace.
No justice.
No peace.
Come on. No justice.
No peace.
No justice.
No peace.
Come on. No justice.
No peace.
That's right. No justice.
No peace.
How's everybody feeling? How's everybody feeling? Let's listen more. Let's make sure. Let's make sure they hear us in here to make a powerful statement this evening.
Right.
Isn't this a symbolic place, a historic place as it is? About 6-7 months ago, we held a hunger strike right here on 17th of Valencia, y'all. Yeah. Yes, the hunger for justice, which helped us get rid of y'all ex-boss, Chief Greg Serb. Noise for that. Rest in peace, Jessica Nelson. So we're here to claim this space for however long we roll, Whitley.
Yeah.
And we're here to put George Gascon, the district attorney of San Francisco, on Front Street. We're going to expose him, and we need him to prosecute these police officers involved with all the murders since he's been in range of his district attorney position. So we have a list of Amilcar Perez, Mario Woods, O'Shane Evans, Alex Nieto, Kenneth Harden, Luis Gongora, and Jessica Nelson.
Yeah.
And the list goes on and will continue. And we have a lot more people that's going to join us. I hope that everybody sticks around, because this is not just for us to protest, of course, but we're here to bring awareness to this neighborhood and these people that walk by. So make sure you grab some flyers, hold these signs, just line up and have the spirit of the community and the love that we all know that we can share with each other right now. This is a beautiful moment, I believe. So let's get these signs, let's pass out all the literature that we have to all these people that's passing by, hopefully, to be close. And we have some people that's going to step up to the microphone and say what they're saying. Yes, yes, power to the people. Can I get a power?
Power to the people!
Can I get a power to the people?
Power to the people!
I gotta bring my brother up, my man who did the hunger strike, and a very close friend of mine out here fighting for justice, San Francisco native. Make some noise for my brother Ike Pinkston, y'all.
Yeah!
Thank you, sir. Thank you, thank you. Wow. Back so soon?
Yeah.
I haven't even heard to you yet.
This time you can eat.
I know, right? Man, I know it was last second, but it's definitely awesome to see this many people out here, regardless whether it would have been 5 of us, 10 of us. Justice got to be served, man. We can't be out here out in these streets afraid of the people sworn to protect. And so, the first thing that comes to mind, I'm just wondering how many of these guys even grew up in the community that they say that they serve. And I know growing up, I'm older than some of these guys even sitting out here, so. But, you know, when I was asked to come out here and talk about what's going on and the prosecution of police officers and whatnot, I went to Google because I'm like, you know, what really is the purpose of the DA? So I actually went to Google because I didn't want to be ignorant. I didn't want to be out here with a microphone in my hands just throwing out a whole bunch of BS. So I went there, and the first thing that pops up, it says, generally the duties of a district attorney are to manage the prosecutor's office, investigate alleged crimes in cooperation with law enforcement, and file criminal charges or bringing evidence before the grand jury. Now, I don't know about you. I've seen a lot of videos of police officers unnecessarily killing unarmed civilians. And if that's not enough evidence to bring before a grand jury, I really don't know what the fuck is. When you have people with their hands up in the air, I don't care if they have a knife in their hand, a lot of these people don't have anything. And you have people on the side of the roads and broken down vehicles. You have people who are verbal officers that they have a permit to carry, reaching for identification, getting shot. You have people sitting in parks, eating lunch before they go to work, getting shot by officers 40-plus times. I don't know about you. I've never seen a burrito that I felt threatened by. It's a travesty that we have these uniformed people with guns and tasers, handcuffs, and all this so-called training, but yet the first thing they do is commit more violence upon more violence upon more violence upon more violence in our community. And enough is enough. This has got to stop. It can't be this way. Where this is 2016, okay? We basically are reverting back to what it was like in the slavery days when. And do you not even know that your job description, when first instituted, was to go and catch runaway slaves and bring them back to the owners? And don't you find it very peculiar that even back in those days they didn't kill the slaves? And you had to bring back the property so that that property could continue to make money. But now rolls are switched, because now you guys hate to kill us. You get your little extravagant vacations while there's a so-called investigation, and at the end of the vacation, we get a jury or whatever investigation says that it's justified. And when I think of the Amilcar Lopez, I'm sickened by that. I am so sickened that we live in a society that can stay in a situation where a man eating a burrito by himself, his own business. Even the person who called 911 testified and said it wasn't really the situation that he was reporting, that it was unnecessary force that the officers were using. And you have the person that actually called 911 saying that the force was unnecessary, and come on. So at some point, we got to get justice, where we get to revert back to that trial with Jessica. Somehow, some way, Gascon, if we can't get Gascon to do it, we need another DA. So we need to remove Gascon the same way we moved. The same way we're about to remove at least the people. Yep. We have power. And the reason why they're killing us is they don't want us to use that power. And if we continue to allow to use that power, that they win. And we can't allow them to win. It's beautiful when I stand out here and I see all the different colors and different faces, different nationalities, different age groups out here. We got old, young, in between, and everything. And I don't mean to say old, I should say elderly. Because old is a state of mind, and I don't think anybody here is. I'm an OG. I think I just graduated about a week ago. But yes, people, we got to be out here, whether it's every day, every week, whatever long, however long it takes. It doesn't stop at the election, because we know the election is just going to get worse after that. Who's sitting in office, whether it's Trump or whether it's Hillary, we're not going to be for the next 4 years with whatever bullshit we're going to have to deal with.
To be honest with you,
I really think the election is an opportunity for all of us to come closer together as a community, because we are going to need each and every one of us to stick together, because the election, as you is driving a wedge between everyone, between all races, between all standards of,
whatever you want to call it. I don't want to be out here talking too much because I'll go all day. because I'm just really passionate about just for people. I'm tired of seeing people who aren't really, who didn't grow up in my community, police in my community, killing the people in my community.
Yeah.
So, I don't know who's next to speak. Opportunity for just listening to me.
Yeah.
I pour out my heart.
Yeah.
Make some noise for your brother I.K.C. Come on, make some noise for your brother.
Yeah.
That is, whatever the hip thing is, raise the roof, I'm old, huh? That's right. Can we get a power to the people?
Power to the people!
All power to the people!
Power to the people!
That's what I'm talking about. I'm going to bring up this next brother that's been with the Alice Nietos. The Nietos, the family, and from the gate. And this brother's a frontliner. He's out there. He's got a beautiful heart. He's from the city, same area that I grew up in. So y'all make some noise for my brother Oscar Salinas, y'all.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. How's everybody feeling today?
Good.
We need justice.
Fucking months
since Amilcar Perez shot in the back 6 times.
Yeah.
We are tired of waiting. Do we have to post up here in front of Mission Police Station again? Because
yeah.
We will do it.
Yep.
We've been waiting around and we've been demanding for justice. And we're sick and tired of it. We are the ones that got Chief Sir fired.
Yeah.
It wasn't that Lee that fired him.
Nope.
It was us. You,
yeah.
you, and everybody here. And people that are not here right now that are watching were part of the whole process. Because we control this city. They don't control this city. We don't control this city. We control this city. We put pressures on the doors of Mayor Ed Lee time and time again to the point where he was scared to come out. He only came down to Mission Police Station when he felt safe to come down here. And that's not the way we roll. If you're going to come to our communities and try to kill us, you think that we're going to sit down?
Hell no!
Can I get a hell no?
Hell no!
Can I get a hell no?
Hell no!
Alex Nieto was killed on March 21st, 2014. Within days, we went up to that hill and we marched. And hundreds of people from the community came out from every neighborhood, from every race, because they knew it was not right. And of course, the media criminalizes every victim every time. Mario Woods, Amilcar Perez, Luis Gonzalez Pat, a homeless man on 19th and Shawwell, gunned down within 30 seconds of SFPD coming out.
Yep.
That right there is criminal, and it is bullshit, I tell
yeah.
you. That is bullshit, I tell you. And that's the reason why we're out here, and that's the reason why I stand out here in solidarity with all of you. Because Diego Gascon, this shit has been on your table for 20 months. You need to do your job, and you need to do it right now, because it is time, because we're sick and tired of waiting, and we're going to start continue knocking on your door every Friday. We will be at the Amazon store. If we have to be right here in front of Mission Police Station, we will be in front of police station here. We've done it before. We've brought worldwide attention to the city of San Francisco
yeah.
and to the corruption that happens in this city. From all the text messages, all the racist text messages, from everything that you've seen, and you know that they are corrupt.
Yep.
So that's the reason we're out here. Amilcar Perez shot 6 times in the back. How hard is that to sit there and say, you know what? We need to prosecute these officers. Prosecute them, right?
Yep. Yep.
That's how we're here. And we'll continue doing this.
Yep.
Because just because you thought that we're silent after the hunger strike, it doesn't mean we have not been planning things. Believe me, we're going out with a bang in 2016, and we're coming back in 2017. And we are going to shut down the city.
Yeah.
So give me a hell yeah.
Hell yeah.
Hell yeah.
Hell yeah.
I'm all for Alex.
I'm all for Alex.
I'm all for Amilcar Perez. brother, Oscar Salinas. Make some noise. Come on, let's make some noise. Yeah. Come on, y'all. Yeah. That's what I'm talking about. I'm about to introduce my sister. That's been a part of what's going on, a part of my life, a part of what's going on in San Francisco, on the front lines, behind the scenes, and things like that. And she's one of my favorite people. Why don't y'all make some noise for my sister, Yaini Aviva, y'all.
The community. They are here to protect and serve corporations and property.
Like always.
We see it in Dakota.
Yeah.
We see it here every day in the streets of San Francisco. Anyone of color, unarmed, is considered a threat. And DA Gascon says, I can't bring charges unless I know I'm going to win the case.
Wow.
That's what he said to me in person. That's what he said to other people.
Wow.
Let's get one thing clear, Gascon. It's not about your political career and how good you look in the courtroom. It's about justice for the people. It's about justice for the families who lost their children unarmed, and the only crime was being black and looking suspicious. So every day, we need to remind Gascon that we did not elect him so he could advance his political career.
Yeah.
We elected him to do his job, and he needs to do it now.
Yeah.
There's no more of if I can win the case. You have to understand the Peace Officers' Bill of Rights. The Peace Officers' Bill of Rights is not working for the people. It's working for killer cops. It's working for sexual predators in uniform.
Yeah.
It's working for people who send text messages talking about lynching and burning crosses.
Yeah.
And when I look behind me at these officers of color, I say shame on you. I don't know how you can go to work and deal with a community and a work culture that oppresses your own people.
Yeah.
Maybe it's $700,000+ a year that's more important than your community, but the community is speaking back, and we say no more. And from this point forward, we will hold you accountable, and we will hold DA Gascon accountable.
Yeah.
Tell it to the people.
Hold the people.
Where's he?
Behind you.
My sister. Make some noise for Yanni, y'all. Come on, make some noise.
Yeah.
We got a storm, we got power out here, we got the energy. So I'm about to bring up, where's my mama out here, my second mama. I want you to make some noise for this woman that's about to hit the microphone, and she's been on the front line for many years, and she's about to pour her heart out and let it know, and I hope that y'all can, you know what I'm saying, open up and appreciate her. So, ready, baby? Make some noise for Misha, y'all. We need you to stay.
Yeah.
Come on, here she
is
here, y'all. Make some noise for Misha.
My beautiful people, I don't have much to say today, but to remind us that the police department keeps hiring killers.
Yeah.
Okay? Officer Lacayo, that little mafi one, who is now pulling his steroids, killed Derek James, who was a 16-year-old disabled black child in South City in 2012. He's now working in the Mission District. He has brutalized Travis, a kid with special needs, was 19, a black kid. He has brutalized and sexually harassed Jean from Police of 5, and he continues. Chaplain, or whoever comes after you, stop hiring known killers. Not only that, but we want the Lord to kill our Nieto. Want the Lord to kill Nieto. He's now working in the Bayview. In the Bayview, we got a white cop that says, I came here to be trained on how to kill niggers. Okay, 2016. That's the kind of thing that we hear. That is still roaming the streets after viciously killing a woman who was 8 months pregnant. Okay? Do the police department stop recycling volunteers. How simple is that? Okay? So I hope you ignore the very sarcastic presence behind us here. It's really not worth it because we're going to change it all.
Yeah.
Make some noise for Mama Misha, y'all. Come on.
Yeah, Misha!
Beautiful freedom fighter. We all need to pay homage, and they're not. But y'all feeling good right now? Make some noise, y'all. Come on. It's important we turn this into a beautiful event right now. We got a special guest that we want to bring to the microphone that came out here from New York, and she's with the Answer Coalition, the Answer Organization. If she can come up here and share what's going on in New York. These are our struggles, their struggles, their struggles, our struggles. Make some noise for Rachel, y'all, please.
Thank you, sisters and brothers. My name is Rachel. I'm from the Answer Coalition. I'm also from the Party for Socialism and Liberation. And I'm from New York City. And if y'all know, New York City, we've been going through the same things that happen out here. It's not new. It's not new. It's not isolated, right? Out here, Mario Woods shot more than 20 times out here at Nieto, killed because he has a burrito in his hand. Are we talking about in New York City the same thing? A Todd Gurley gunned down in his building. He gunned down in the streets, right? Everybody being gunned down. Kamani Perry gunned down by the police. Ramazzi Graham killed in his own house when his grandmother was there and she was starving. How are you going to tell me? How are you going to tell me about the specifics of individual cases? It ain't about each individual case. It ain't about that. I don't want to argue with you about what happened to Mike Brown in particular. I don't want to argue with you about what happened to Mario Woods in particular. I want to talk about the fact that every 28 hours, a black or brown person is killed here in America by a security guard, a police officer, or some sort of authority figure. That is the reality of our system. Every single day, black and brown people are being murdered. I'm Filipina. And in the Philippines, there is an NYPD, New York City Police Department in Manila. Because they're exporting it everywhere. They train the police in other countries how to oppress our people there. So that way they can better oppress our people there and oppress our people once we get here. You see, it's a system. And I'm here in solidarity. I'm here, we've done so much work for the Akai Gurley family. I work very closely with Aunt T. Shout out to Aunt T and the amazing work that the family are doing in New York. Right now, we have over 30 people who are coming together, family members who are coming together, who are saying no more, who are standing in solidarity with one another. And I'm standing in solidarity here. Continue to build. I would love to build with y'all because this is systematic. And it's important that we make sure that the system entirely must go. We need a new system. We need an opportunity to have the right to have police who are from our communities living in our communities. Because this ain't new. This ain't just San Francisco. This is everywhere we go. So solidarity, y'all. Please continue to build with me. Continue to build because this movement is changing everything. The work you do out here, how y'all got that chief steward, how you got that happening, man, that's amazing. And every single place around the country, every time we fight back, we win. Every time we fight back, we get something. Right. Akai Gurley, the cop who killed him, Peter Liang, he was a convicted, but the judge overturned it and said, oh no, you're not going to go to jail, not even house arrest, we're not going to give you nothing, you're going to go home to your family. But because we fought so hard, we were able to get an opportunity, just an opportunity, to be able to convict the first police officer and what, over like 20 years of people on duty? I mean, really, like, no police officer has gone to jail, period, for the fact that we have murdered people on blood. So, the more we fight back, the more we win. In Standing Rock, we are winning. We are winning across the country. So, solidarity and love to y'all. Thank you for letting me get up here and share.
Yeah!
Thank you for your sister, Rachel. New York. All right. I'm about to bring up my young brother. Y'all ready to get hyped up a little bit?
Yeah!
Who wanted to hear us? Who wanted to hear us and kill us? All right?
I know we're here!
Make some noise for young Michael, y'all.
Michael!
Come on, let's
hear
us. Yeah!
No justice! No peace!
No racism!
Police!
No justice!
No peace!
No racism!
Police!
No justice!
No peace!
No racism!
Police!
How do you spell
We don't get no justice. I lost my body in San Francisco on October 7th, 2014. Officer David Goff shot me dead in my car in the baseball game. I was unarmed. Justice for O'Shea. Presente.
Soy Amilcar Perez-Lopez, 20 años de edad, inmigrante de Guatemala, y perdí mi cuerpo en San Francisco el 15 de febrero, casi enfrente de mi casa en la calle Pozo, balaceado por dos policías de la misión. La autopsia determinó que fui balaceado por la justicia para Amilcar.
Simone Real, 57, an immigrant from Fiji Island. I lost my body in San Francisco on August 2nd, 2015. I was tased, pepper sprayed, and beaten to death by 8 cops while I was experiencing a mental health crisis. I was unarmed. Rest in power, Simone. Presente.
Presente.
Alexander Brown, 24, white woman struggling with addiction.
Yeah!
I am Alex, and I lost my body in San Francisco. On March 17, 2015, I was shot dead inside of my car off Upper Van Ness Avenue. While I attempted to follow SFPD order and tried to park, I was unarmed. Justice for Alice, presente.
Presente. I am Herbert Benitez, 27, homeless Salvadoran migrante, and I lost my body in San Francisco on October 15, 2015. SFPD shot me dead on Market and 8th Street when I experienced a mental health crisis and threw a bottle on a construction site. I did not have a gun. Justicia para Herbert. Presente.
Presente.
Like them, I don't want to look at you.
I am Mario Wood, 26, African American man, and I lost my body in San Francisco on December 2nd, 2015. Four SFPD Bayview officers shot me multiple times after cornering me against the wall. I was in pain and terrified. I had no gun. Love and justice for Mario.
Presente. Presente. Soy Luis Demetrio Gómez Rapaz, hombre migrante, hombre maya de Yucatán, de 45 años. Balaceado en la misión cerca de mi tienda donde dormía, perdí mi cuerpo en San Francisco el 7 de abril del 2016. Yo había perdido mi apartamento, mi trabajo, no tenía arma. Justicia para Luis Góngora Paz. Presente.
I am Jessica Nelson Williams, 29, African-American, mother of 5 and 8 months pregnant. I lost my body in San Francisco on May 19, 2016, when Bayview Officer Justin Herb shot me dead inside my car. I was unarmed. Justice for Jessica.
Justice.
body in San Francisco on October 7th, 2014. Officer David Goff shot me dead in my car in a baseball game. I was unarmed. Justice for O'Shea. Vicente.
Soy Amilcar Perez-Lopez, 20 años de edad, inmigrante de Guatemala, y perdí mi cuerpo en San Francisco el 15 de febrero, casi enfrente de mi casa en la calle Foso, balaceado por dos policías de la misión. La autopsia determinó que fui balaceado por la justicia para Amilcar.
Out 57 immigrant from Fiji Island. I lost my body in San Francisco on August 2nd, 2015. I was tased, pepper sprayed, and beaten to death by 8 cops while I was experiencing a mental health crisis. I was unarmed. Rest in power, Silamoni. Presente.
Presente.
Alexandra Brown, 24, white woman struggling with addiction.
Yeah!
I am Alice, and I lost my body in San Francisco. On March 17, 2015, I was shot dead inside of my car off Upper Van Ness Avenue. While I attempted to follow SFPD order and try to park, I was unarmed. Justice for Alice, presente.
Presente.
I am Herbert Benitez, 27, homeless Salvadoran migrante, and I lost my body in San Francisco on October 15, 2015. SFPD shot me dead on Market and 8th Street when I experienced a mental health crisis and threw a bottle on a construction site. I did not have a gun. Justicia para Herbert. Presente.
Presente.
Like them, I don't
want to
look at you.
I am Mario Wood, 26, African American man, and I lost my body in San Francisco on December 2nd, 2015. Four SFPD Bayview officers shot me multiple times after cornering me against the wall. I was in pain and terrified. I had no gun. Love and justice for Mario.
Soy Luis Demetrio Góngora Pat, hombre migrante, hombre maya de Yucatán, de 45 años. Balaceado en la misión cerca de mi tienda donde dormía, perdí mi cuerpo en San Francisco el 7 de abril del 2016. Yo había perdido mi apartamento, mi trabajo, no tenía arma. Justicia para Luis Góngora Paz. Presente.
I am Jessica Nelson Williams, 29, African-American mother of 5 and 8 months pregnant. I lost my body in San Francisco on May 19, 2016, when Bayview Officer Justin Herb shot me dead inside my car. I was unarmed. Justice for Jessica.
Justice.
Justice.
on January 4th, 2015. Two SFPD officers shot me dead right in front of the Mission Station parking lot while I was experiencing a mental health crisis. I was unarmed, but they said I was reaching for my waistband. Justice for Matt. Presente.
Presente.
I am Nick McWhirter, 26, white man, homeless, living in my van. I lost my body in San Francisco on October 16, 2016. While experiencing a mental health crisis near Stern Grove, SFPD shot me dead. Justice for Nick. Presente!
Yeah.